everyone for our final conference at the 4th International Week 2019 of Universidad Santo Tomás. We want to tell you that you should do the registration to the talk with the QR code available at the auditorium, and you will participate for a gift at the end of the talk. Now we welcome our lecturer, Professor William Alexander Villalobos, as speaker, who is going to present the topic Education in the Millennial Generation. Professor William is a bachelor in modern languages from Sade University. He also holds a master's degree in education focused on didactics from Universidad Libre. He did translation studies at the Pontificia Universidad Javeriana. Additionally, he has done several studies in virtual teaching. Currently, he's a full-time professor at USTA for the Languages Institute. He also works at Pontificia Universidad Javeriana as a virtual instructor. At the present, he leads the virtual teaching learning processes at the Languages Institute Friar Bernardo de Lugo, OT. His researchers are aimed at the use of virtual tools to support the teaching of foreign languages. Professor Villalobos designs, implements, and administrates virtual platform for language teaching. Please welcome him to the stage. Thank you for accepting the invitation.
Good morning, everybody. How are you doing today? Good? Fine? Tired? Hungry? So-so, a little bit? Okay. So I'm just going to take some 30, 45 minutes to talk about this nice topic that is focused on millennials. Do you really understand what millennials mean? Raise your hand if you think you're a millennial. Millennials, raise your hand. Okay, thank you. So, who are millennials? So, probably sometimes we don't understand, you know, we say millennials and we call everybody millennials, but we don't really understand what millennials mean. You know, like, generation. So, we usually, you know, like, stick things from the United States, you know, and of course, one of the things is, you know, speaking about population. So in the United States and, you know, developed countries, they usually talk about populations. You know, they divide populations into different categories. So I belong to a category or, you know, like stage of life. You know, depending on the age, you two, and depending on the age, you know, we're going to call them, you know, generations. So who are millennials? So if we're born, you know, between 1977 and 2000, you are millennial. So, because sometimes people think, you know, the millennials are who are born, you know, after 2000, but it's not, you know, it's before 2000, you know. These guys were the ones who finished, you know, this millennium. So, we're going to speak about this generation because I think it's something really important. So, before speaking about this and dealing with education, I really want to focus my presentation, you know, on the largest population among the time. So we can say, you know, that we can have, you know, like different generations. For example, the first one that is only 9% is speaking about the United States. Again, you know, some things are copied, you know, are brought from the United States here, and sometimes we don't really know, you know, what it means. So speaking about, you know, like the first generation that is 1925 to 1945 is, you know, is called, you know, the silent generation. Then it comes with the baby boomers. That is the next generation with the 23%. Then it's going to be the X generation, you know, the 1968 till 1980. And then, you know, the famous, you know, generation, millennial generation. So there are people, you know, between more or less, you know, 1981, 1997 or 2000. You know, it's about these kind of people. So, and well, and then the people, you know, that are coming, you know, like for example, you know, like people who are 16, 17, 18 even, before, you know, they are called the Generation Z. All right, so we're going to focus on these people, you know, millennials. So to talk about these people, of course, we need to concentrate on some characteristics, some features about these guys. Again, I really want to focus, you know, your attention on people from different cultures, like for example, the United States or Europe. You know, we are different cultures, you know. And of course, this information might be similar to our country, but it's more focused on the United States that, you know, they really talk about millennials. We sometimes talk about here about millennials, but as I told you at the beginning, we don't really know about much about this topic, no? So some features, you know, like this is a study, you know, according to pool research, you know, that the 50% of these people, you know, this generation, you know, they are between 37 years old and 19, 20 years old. So this, you know, this is part. These people think, you know, there are three important factors, you know, that is political factor, religious, and authority. So most of these people, you know, they are different, for example, from me or generation, you know, like the previous generations. Why? Because, for example, in my case, or if you talk to your parents, you know, or your grandparents, you know, they're gonna be pretty respectful, you know, if you talk about politics, religious, and authority. You know, just talk to your father, talk to your mother, talk to your grandfather, grandmother, and tell them about religious, tell them about politics. Okay, so their mind is different. Why? Because it's a different generation. Okay, so these people, you know, let's call them, you know, more independent. So the millennial generation, you know, they are more independent when they talk about politics. For example, and even you guys, you know, previously, you know, we were focused on two different political parties, conservador, liberal. Now it's different. You know, we can get, you know, among of political parties, and then you are the one who are going to decide, you know, which vote is going to go for each party or not. So this is really important, you know, the same as religious, no? Previously, you know, like some 30, 40 years ago, you know, even more, you know, the religious was really important, you know, the Catholic religious was really important. Nowadays it changed, you know, like some people don't follow this kind of religious, or sometimes, you know, they are, you know, like following different religious, but nowadays, you know, it's changing. Why? Because it's different population. Now, technology is the thing most important when we talk about millennials. Why? Because, you know, millennials, you know, when they were babies, when they were born, you know, they were the first ones to use Facebook, for example. You know, they were the first ones to use internet. All right, so that's why this generation is that important. Of course, you do it and I do it, and of course we do it. But you know, the fact that these people use the first time to use Facebook and internet is really important. So technology is so important. You know, they were the last generation, as I told you, that generation born in the 20s. They think, you know, like learning is really important. You know, it's different. You already know that, for example, face-to-face classes are really good. You love face-to-face classes. But nowadays you can have the opportunity to get, you know, e-learning. You know, according to these statistics and this study, you know, these kind of people, some of them are lazy, you know, like lazy. Others are, you know, like narcissistic. They love themselves. Okay, they really like what they do. They really like, you know, like to be all the time, you know, like thinking about themselves, you know, using the kind of piercing or tattoos or different things like this. You know, it's growing and growing and growing. They also like traveling, you know, these kind of people, they love traveling everywhere, be traveling, be moving all the time, you know and visit different cultures. And when we talk about parents, you know, because of course you already have parents, you know, millennial parents, both, you know, they usually have the same responsibility. Nowadays, you know, women go to university and go to work. Before it was different. Talk to your father or probably to your grandmother, you know, and usually mother stays home and father goes to work. No? So that is something that is really changing a lot. Okay, good. So now we're going to take a look, you know, at the importance of technology, because technology is something really important for millennials. Of course, nowadays, you know, the last generation, the one that we are living, but of course for these people, again, 37, 20, above, you know, people who are this age. So as I told you, these people grew up, you know, with computers and internet. So as a matter of fact, they need internet all the time. You know, everywhere they go, you know, they are just chatting, they are searching information, they are researching, they are looking for jobs, they are doing all the time because they are the experts. You know, this generation are the really experts because, again, they were born with internet. Again, you know, in schooling, these people think, you know, the importance of using internet. Sometimes, you know, like, we're going to take a look a little bit about it, you know, like comparison between previously and now, or this era, and, you know, the importance of technology. You know, nowadays technology is really important in your classes, and even, you know, for self-study. Well, they are really dependent to international public. For example, you know, you can see the picture, you know, they are all the time like chatting, and you know, you can see here in the auditorium some people, you know, like for sure they are millennials, they are chatting or they are just using the internet because they live, they're independent. I mean, they are dependent to this gadget. And that's good, no? That's you know, a generation, of course, you know, people should respect. Because one thing is like, you know, sometimes, you know, I was just searching on internet and trying to read, you know, some researches. And they think, you know, some people think that, you know, that this generation is bad. And it's, you know, it's one of the best generations. Because they are multiple tasks. They do everything at the same time. So they can do everything. If you push them to do it, they can do many things. We're going to talk a lot about the parents' role. You know, the parents are very important for this generation. So for this generation, and nowadays, of course, remember I'm talking about, you know, this generation, you know, the Z generation, the millennials. You can see, you know, that before, you know, like, let's say some 30, 35 years ago, you know, parents used to, you know, like, take care more of kids. Because as I told you, you know, mothers, you know, were at home, you know, like raising kids. Now this is different. And in that time, you know, like 1997, 96, you know, mothers started to, you know, to take care of kids, but not the same as previously. So it means, you know, like the kids were not, you know, taken care by them, but a nanny or by teachers at school, or by themselves or friends. So it's something really important to, you know, to take into account. You know, previously, you know, these parents take kids to school. Nowadays, you know, they go by bicycle. You know, they're more independent. Okay, and as I told you before, you know, there were little time to talk. You know, some statistics about, you know, education options for this generation, and most of the statistics, you know, they're mentioned here in this study, they think, you know, that the virtual study is really important for millennials. Okay, good. You know, when it comes to talk about both teachers and students, both millennials, so they agreed, you know, that this is a, you know, education is a big responsibility and it's not easy. Why? Because it's a change. Just imagine, again, talk to your parents or talk to your grandparents and just ask them the way they were taught. You know, the classes were different. You know, teachers were different. It was like a magister class, you know, like everybody, you know, like just paying attention, like having in mind, memorizing, but not analyzing. On the contrary, this generation, you know, what they do was to change, you know, the mind of people and try to start just thinking on more demanding things, like, for example, the critical thinking. Let's focus a little bit on traditional teaching. You know, it was like some long time ago. You know, like, for example, you know, you can see some pictures here, you know, like, and this is pretty long, but eventually you can say, you know, like, some, I don't know, some 30 years ago, some 35, 40 years ago, it was quite similar. You know, like 50 students in a classroom, you know, everybody, you know, like goals, like lines, you know, the teacher was the last word, was the boss, was the chief, nobody could speak, now it's different. Okay, why? Because, of course, you know, things are changing. In that time, you know, people or students, you know, were supposed to memorize, you know, and how important is to memorize? You know, memorization is good as long as there is meaningful memorization. It means that you're going to think critically and you're going to use, you know, all the things you memorize to apply. That is something very important. But in that time, before millennials, you know, the traditional learning or teaching, you know, memorization was really important, that in my opinion is not that good. For example, you know, most of you guys know that I'm an English teacher, and I remember, because I'm not a millennial, I'm the previous generation, and I remember, you know, my classes, for example, when I was at school, or as a teacher too, you know, these formulas, for example, to learn, you know, like the structures in English, and well, of course, that is something really bad. Why? Because the students, you know, they are going to focus on the structure, but they are not going to focus on production and communication. No? So that is a brief example about, you know, the way, you know, these traditional classes work. What about the changes? Of course, you know, changes are big, you know, and you can see, you know, like the pictures, that, like the way, like you guys, you can be chatting, or you can be, you know, like searching information from here to China in a click, you know? So you're going to click just on your mobile phone, and you're going to find everything you have. So you have everything on hand. Everything is here. So for this generation, of course, what's really important, you know, because before, you know, they change, you know, like the facts of, you know, the knowledge, the basic, the fact-based information knowledge, you know, was much more important. These people, you know, they really want, as you guys, you know, you want to learn more about. For example, you have your mobile phone or your gadget, and then you're waiting for a new one. You know, because, I mean, this generation, you know, they really want to get new technologies, new application, new use of technologies to make your life faster and to make your life easier. Now, what about e-learning? You know, e-learning, you know, as I told you, for these people, for you still, is really important. Why? Because, for example, here at the university, we have different platforms. For example, the one we use right here, that is Moodle. And depending on the subject you are taking, you know, you're going to learn based on platforms. So platforms are really important, so the e-learning is really important. Nowadays, for example, the university, you know, they offer virtual classes. Probably you are thinking of, you know, like, instead of traveling, if you have the chance to travel to Europe, the United States, Canada, it will be good. But if you don't really have money, you can take, you know, like virtual masters, you know, or majors, or even you can take some diploma courses on internet. So just by sitting in front of your box with computer and you're going to take, you study by yourself. So that is something really good because that is more autonomous. Well, the traditional learning, as I told you, is more like face-to-face, you know, like teaching students to memorize and not to think critically and to, you know, like to give opinions about topics. What is the teacher responsibility? Well, the teacher responsibility for these people, of course, that is really important, but it's really difficult. Why is it difficult? Because, for example, a teacher who was, you know, like 40 years old and the kid was 7 years old, you know, these kids, you know about technology. Probably you see in YouTube, you can see videos, kids, you know, like 1 year old and kids with tablets or mobile phones, and they are just clicking and doing really stuff on these computers. So just pretend to be a teacher, you know, in that time. Nowadays it's different. Nowadays we teachers, we need to improve and like we say in Spanish, no ir con a mano de los estudiantes. Because if the teacher, you know, doesn't know how to open an application, well, in front of the student, the student is not going to believe. So that's why it's really important, you know, the teacher's responsibility. You know, to teach students something demanding. These students, you know, as I told you before, you know, they might be lazy, you know, lazy, perezoso, they might, podría ser, but it depends on the person who is in front. Because if you demand the students, if you demand, you know, like the employees of the generation to do and to improve and to do things, they for sure are going to do it because it's a really good generation. We need to talk about academic and we also need to talk about connection. When I say connection, it's personal. Because they feel, you know, because they feel. And before, you know, students, they were treated in a different way, you know, like trying to, not to feel, you know, like the way a human should feel. So nowadays, you know, teachers were supposed to, you know, to help students by talking, by quotation, being friends, and by trying to approach this generation. So for this generation, there was something really important that is relevance. You know, relevance on what? You know, to update teaching skills. As I told you, you know, it's really difficult. Nowadays, you know, teachers are being trained. But well, again, you know, like some time ago, like some 20, 30 years ago, you know, that was difficult for teachers, you know, who didn't know how to use a mobile phone, who didn't know how to search on internet, who didn't know how to teach a class, you know, used by using technology. Now this is different, and again, you know, a teacher should help you, you know, with these tools. Help these students, you guys, and the previous ones, and of course the generation that continues studying, you know, to approach knowledge, you know, to understand knowledge. The most important, you know, the process, the learning process. if you understand knowledge and then you apply what you understood, so the process is going to be 100% fulfilled. But if you just understand, you know, and get the knowledge, but you don't know how to apply, well, that is going to be, you know, like loose. You know, for these people, and even for you guys, you are not interested in you know, books. Books are not that interesting nowadays, because your book can be on your mobile phone. You know, everything is on your mobile phone, on your tablet. So that's why it's really important for teachers, especially for teachers, you know, to use the technology. I don't know how many of you guys go to the library, you know, library biblioteca, no? If you visit the library, probably the Virgilio Barco, you know, those big libraries we have here at the university. So every day, you know, people are just attending less and less. Why? Because again, everything you can have by here. So you have some homework to do, you have a research to do, just two clicks and you're going to find everything, no? That's why, you know, paper is not really used nowadays. Nowadays and in that time. Again, creativity, you know, you can find everything. And even you don't need to go to classes. You know, you don't need to go to class. You can find everything in YouTube, for example, even in Facebook. You know, you can, for example, you can learn something. I mean, you don't understand in your classes something and you can go, you know, like Facebook. You can go to, you know, like YouTube, even those games we play, you know, Kahoot. Because everything is on internet. So it's really important, again, you know, the role of the teacher is really important for the students. Because if the teacher is not demanding, the teacher is not creative, well, the class is going to be boring and the student is going to be more focused on technology and learn from technology and not for the face-to-face classes. These people, this generation, you know, they really love, you know, the collaborative work. You know, they really like working in groups. I don't know if that happens to you. You know, but the research says, you know, that most of the people, most of this generation, the millennials, they really like, you know, like working in groups, researching in groups, all the time being, you know, like pair work. So it's something really important. What about feedback? You know, feedback, retroalimentación. Feedback is really important. Why? Because these students, this not only students, this generation, because I'm talking about students because I'm a teacher, but of course, you know, any kind of field, you know, at a workplace, in any way. So feedback is really important, you know, it's really key. You know, why? Because these people need to know how they're doing on what they're doing. If they're making mistakes and what the mistakes they are making, you know, how they can improve. So feedback is really important, not only by saying, okay, you got this incorrect, but you're gonna say why, the real feedback. You're gonna do feedback on tasks. What is to give feedback on tasks? You know, at the same time you are researching, so you're going to give feedback, and then things are gonna improve, and little by little, you know, the last task is gonna be perfect, or almost is gonna be a little bit perfect. And what I told you, know, they need to know how they're doing. Okay, and some expectations for this generation, you know. The first one is, you know, something they say, change me and let me change you. It means, you know, and you can see, and you, most of you guys, as I told you, you are millennials. And new generation, you know, the last generation. And then, of course, I mean, you know, you can have the teacher or the person who is in front, you know, but also you can teach that person. You know what I mean? It's like, for example, you know, like when a teacher is teaching something, but then, let's speak about English again, but then you have a study, you travel to the States or Canada, and then not only by giving, you know, like the explanation, you can be taught your students, excuse me, but also you can receive from your students because they have experience. This generation and you guys, you know, you have lots of experiences. Why? Because again, because of technology. Because you can find technology everywhere and because you are going to find every class and knowledge, you know, in these tools. Then it says, don't teach me, argue my experience. What is that, you know? These people and these millennials, you know, they prefer not to be taught like by reading, you know, hundreds of pages, but much better by experience. So they prefer to, you know, to be taught by experiences instead of being just reading or having something important on books. No, you know, these people prefer to be, you know, like following, learning, you know, by experience from the teacher, from the boss, from the leader, and of course from the millennial. these people, you know, the millennials are excellent entrepreneurs. As I told you, some people, if you go through internet, you know, there are some YouTube videos that say, los millennials acabarán el mundo. There are many videos speaking about millennials. Why? Because they don't want to have babies. Why? Because they don't respect, you know, no, because they are more independent on politics, religious, and what I told you before. No, I mean, that's something good. Because then you're not going to follow, you know, what everybody follows. You know, so it's really important, you know, for this, to help these people to build, you know, their knowledge and to become excellent, you know, entrepreneurship. Then it says, prepare me for a father world. You know, the world is changing, you know, everything is changing. And then it says, they say, it's a saying, you know, prepare me, you know, for a world that is changing, that is easier, that is faster. So prepare me, and then I'm going to respond, you know, depending on how much you prepare. And then finally, inspire me and give me freedom and responsibility. You know, that is something they demand, or they ask, you know, leaders or people who are in front of them, because they are good. Because you ask them to do something, and they are going to do it better than the way you are expecting. Okay, and finally, it was easy, it was faster. Finally, you know, we're going to sum up by saying, you know, the most important about this millennial generation. So something to have in mind. Remember, if you are a millennial, the first thing you got to take into account is, you know, people between 37 and 20 about, and then the next generation is going to be the last generation. So for this millennial generation, remember that it's very important, you know, the collaborative work. They like working in groups, they like working together. Number two, you know, the feedback. They need to be, you know, like taught, they need to be given all the mistakes they are making, and also they need to learn about those mistakes. Technology, you know, that is essential, is number one. The most important about millennials is technology. Why? Because they were the first ones to use technology. When I say internet, and you know, those social networking. And finally, mentorship, you know, they need somebody to help them. It means they need somebody to push them to do, to work, to produce. So as the previous one, it says, inspire me and give me freedom and responsibility. That's the last one, the mentor. The mentor is the teacher, the person who is in front of them, the boss, the leader. So you inspire me, and then I'm going to do my best, you know, in everything what I have to do. Okay, my name is William Villalobos. Thank you for coming. If you are a millennium, continue working, because you are good guys. Thank you.
Institución de Educación Superior, sujeta a inspección y vigilancia por el Ministerio de Educación Nacional.